All right, and we're recording. All right, you guys, welcome on in. We're just doing the meeting, so this is not the official podcast, but if there are some conversations that are pertinent to the podcast, I will make sure to include those in it. So today's very special because even though it's still a meeting, we have a new guest with us that I'm co-streaming with, and I would love it if you guys follow. So if this part of the video does make it in the last edit, I will include that also in the description box of the YouTube for Dark Lord Nova. So you want to introduce yourself real quick to everyone that doesn't know you?
Let's go. Hey, I'm Nova. I go by Dark Lord Nova. Nova, Dark, Healer, whatever you want to call me, doesn't matter. I stream Paladins like once a month, maybe. It's gotten so inconsistent recently, but I do stream and I do small amounts of YouTube. Right now my content kind of leans towards finding bugs, and then every now and then I'll post like a game with no audio, so it's just straight gameplay.
I do like the video you were showing me about Omen though, because like I was Raze, you might appreciate that video too. Like, he was showing it to me and I just love in the video he's like, I don't support this, I'm not doing this to show you. Like, I love that you give that disclaimer, because a lot of people be saying like, oh, I do, I have videos on that, but there's no disclaimer anywhere to not, like, they don't disavow it either. So it's like,
I mean, yeah, if I don't say something, I play Omen a lot. He's like one of my highest level champions. People will 100% accuse me of bug abusing.
Yeah.
If I played Omen and I didn't say something about it.
Yeah. That's how Ava was with Drogos.
No one even knows about the bug.
Oh no, like I love Omen. Like after I picked him up, like I just sit there and then like when I figured out about the bug, I was like, do I hate this bug? This is getting all
Yeah.
Which bug are you referring to, by the way?
I have the bug where I just get stuck in specific animation.
See? Like that's the animation. One that's a different one.
Yeah,
do
that's
you know the
one I...
Do you know the bug where he gets perfect accuracy? Despite spread
no, I have never gone.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's what we'd be getting fucked up by.
That's a big one.
I can shoot, but I don't.
There's a headshot in everyone from long distance.
Yeah.
I have the bug where I can shoot like super fast, but it does no damage. And then I get the bugs where I'm just getting, you know, stuck in skill animations.
Yeah, I can explain how both of those work and how it happens. So the one where you have infinite fire rate is affected by your ult. It's an old bug where you could place your ult too far from you and it would mess up your entire kit. And it just, it becomes client side, where you're playing the animation of things, but nothing's happening. And then the other bug is when an enemy goes CC as you grab them. It bugs out your grab to where you can't do anything because you're stuck in the CC of your grab.
That's the one that I get stuck a lot is my CC.
Now there's a third
one. That's why I stopped playing.
No one knows, and this is the big one. Omen has a bug where, do you remember his old talent that got removed? Where you had like perfect accuracy?
Yeah.
Right. So you know how it started at a really low fire rate?
Yeah.
There's a way with any talent except the second one now, where you can get that same talent back with the first or third talent and have the max accuracy of tap fire. So it's perfectly pinpoint with the range.
Bubble bubbles with the umbral lance. Or puddles.
Yeah. I'm not going to say how to do it.
But it's the fact that people know and do abuse it is just ridiculous.
Like, don't tell people.
It is such a weird way to get it, but it's so incredibly easy. I'm not gonna list how to do it because it'd be abused way too easily.
Right.
But
I don't want to know how to do it because
it's too tempting.
He's like, it's
right,
tempting.
Exactly. I'm gonna see like an opportunity to be like, I just want to see if this works.
No, you can. I will put it like this: if you know how to do it, you can pull it off in a game 100% of the time with zero difficulty. It's that easy.
Wow,
that's ridiculous to me. Yeah.
Yeah. No, I'm not saying
it's
shameful.
It is just ridiculous, though.
Here's a shameless plug. If you want to see the bug, go to my YouTube channel and watch
the
video.
Do that shit.
There you go.
Yeah.
There you go.
That's what I was waiting. I was like waiting for him to like plug the video. I was like, pretty sure. The build up. The suspense. The horror. So when you see a bunch of fucking omens shitting on everyone, it's all your fault.
got my package for Gengar. Like, I'm keeping.
You guys, let me tell you, poor Raze, the T. If you ever get a package from me, like a giveaway package, let me know what your mailbox looks like so I can ship it in the appropriate size. Because I never want to ship you something that is a hassle for you to get. Because I feel so bad.
I didn't even expect. I thought the parcel.
It was not that big of a parcel. Because the parcel I sent you before that one was bigger. So I'm like, how did this one get?
Well, see, this one, it was just like, you know, the guy knew it was like some, you know, malleable. Like, he knew it was like a pillow or something soft. So he kind of just stuffed it in my, like, normal mailbox. He didn't put it in the parcel mailbox. But since this one was like, you know, a different size box, he couldn't fit it in my mailbox. My mailbox is.
It's because there's a painting in it, I think.
Oh, see, that's probably why.
And it's square. I bet that's why. Because that was a part of your giveaway stuff. And that, not all of it. You guys, he won so much shit, not all of it fit in one box. I had to spend 2 shipping labels to ship that shit to him.
Ray's been on a winning streak.
Ray's been winning so much shit. And I'm like, other people can win. I'd be trying to, like, get everybody. Andrew Chicken raided me. Like, when was that? That was Friday? When did he raid me? That was Friday or Saturday? One of those days that he raided me, mad motherfuckers was in here. We had mad giveaways, right? And everybody, I think I met a GM this way. It was so funny. Who was it? Oh my god, I forget his name already. This fucking, I don't know.
Dang, that's so
damn
mean, Allie.
I feel so bad now because he was name? Because he was so chill too. Wait, I gotta remember. Hold on, I'm like super high right now. What the fuck was his name? It starts with a C. Crispy? No, Snappy. It was Snappy. Oh my god, I can't believe I forgot Snappy. That's terrible. I'm terrible. Don't tell him I forgot him. It was called Snappy. He's amazing. I feel terrible. So he came in, right? And he was laughing at the fact that nobody was like claiming. Like we called, I think, how many people? Like 6. And we gave them about a minute.
Wheel of Names thing when Andrew.
Yeah.
I'm waiting for the day I get an Andrew raid.
Dude, I'm telling you right now, you have to do it. So he always starts at what, 2, right? Is it 2 or 1?
Yeah.
That's when I sleep is the bad part.
No! You were up for 30 hours. You gotta get your shit together.
He goes,
bro, I got you. I'll DM you the schedule.
Demon hours for me.
And he tries to do it for different people, if you notice.
He does. He does. He really does. I'm telling you, he'll get.
I
get them.
Came from an Andrew stream.
Yeah, Justin has been here. Yeah, how many months? Yeah, we adopted you. You're my problem child. When did you get here?
Yeah, I am the problem child.
You are the T. We love you.
How many months am I now? I don't know.
Do your followage thing. You've been here for a while.
How do I do that? I think it's only like 4 or 5 months.
You're not even a whole pregnancy.
What is the command?
It's !! Followage, I think.
Follow edge. A-G-E.
Follow edge. Yeet. 4 months.
Yes, the only 4 months.
Yeah.
Well, I guess 5 months. It's almost like a week.
It's very close. But the fact that you came from that.
I think I got cucked when I did mine. Yeah, see?
You got cucked?
Look,
where can I apply to get cucked?
Back into that.
My follow age is because I changed my name.
What the fuck is Liam saying? Bucks not clucked or some shit? Alright, let me put. So there's a panel
of
yours.
I've been following for way more than 7.
Oh, Lich is in here. I just realized that. Poor thing. What's he doing?
Where is Lich?
I don't know. Being a queen. We love him. But anyways, so... moving on. I don't think I have my chatbot on because it was very distracting last time. So I purposely have it off. Sir.
That's fair.
In case you're wondering, Nova, why the fuck he did !! Me. I have sound commands that are random things, and I'm obsessed with the Arby's. Arby's, we had the meat! So I, like, turned it into a sound command. Because, like, why not?
But we do it at the most awkward
times. We do it at the most awkward times, so everybody's just like, why are we meeting? What the meat? What the meat do? Oh, my God. All right, so let's get into it. So we're talking team comms, emoji video, lore request on champs. So with team comms, I feel like that could be split up in so many ways, if you know what I mean. So how do we want to divide that up? Should we do with like OP versus like what kind of like we would do with meme, with builds?
We should do like meme comps and then And like, you know, like, I guess like some semi-serious comps, like comps that you kind of want to use to win.
So with that being said, are we considering meme comps that are like...
that actually work?
Relatively abusing bugs or no bug comps?
Hold on
like
one second.
No bug comps.
Yes, but you need to wash your hands as
like,
soon as
you're
done.
They're like comps, like, you know, like for like, you know, the silly like TDMs that they do give us sometimes or, you know, this, that, or the other.
Like with Choose Any and stuff.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. I was thinking more of comps centered around certain aspects and kits that are just a little bit broken at the moment.
Ooh.
So like, if you don't know, there. Talus ult plus a Yag ult will insta-kill people.
I have been the victim of that plenty of times by your group. Thank you very much.
So you could run a comp like Nando, Yag, Ray, Talus, and then something like a BK. And you would stun them with the BK, activate the Nando ult, then you would pop the Yag ult so he doesn't die because of Nando ult. And then you'll have the Talus ult that person at the same time and you coordinate it. And then they instantaneously die no matter who it is. So it's a perfect kill. And there's literally nothing anyone can do about it. And because you have Ray, you have a second life for anybody that might get picked during that time.
Right.
And you have the crazy ult charge. So you can cycle this. Like once every 30 seconds of an active fight.
That is so fucking OP.
God, Ray's about to be even more broken. I don't like that.
Yeah, right. No, thank you.
Yeah, that's kind of what I mean by a meme.
Oh,
comp.
Man.
That's using a little
that
bit of bug abuse.
That is definitely a very.
That is meme shit.
Viable.
What did we do the other day that resulted in a win? Oh, I posted that on YouTube. The all fucking support.
The five support.
Yeah, we did five support and we melted, and it was an onslaught, wasn't it?
Yeah.
I'm convinced they were new players or just coming over from Overwatch. One of the two. There's no fucking way at that time of night that they let us win. Like that was just so crazy. I was like, why is this working? It was
just take your wins where you can get them.
True.
Even if it's some weird comp.
True.
Just be happy that you got it. Because you're going to play like some kind of hardcore meta comp and get curb stomped one day. And you're going to hate it.
Which is like 9 out of the 10 games I'll play. I'll have that one weird win and then I'm like, okay, back to losing.
Yeah, the weird wins are the fun ones.
True. That's when I get free games. I was thinking of something and then
like...
I forgot. Damn.
As far as team comps go, like kind of some of the basics also.
Oh,
would
true.
Be, you know, like.
Oh, true. Cover the basics because
like,
we are our
comps.
Audience.
Like, you know, meme comps are good, but like for the legit comps, like you want like a certain composition. Like you want at least like one tank. Usually two tanks is best. That's kind of usually been the meta for the last couple of years. You always need a support because someone has to be the backbone and healing the team.
Yeah, I guess explaining that too.
Mm-hmm.
Right, have we already started the discussion? Or are we still doing the outline for it?
No. But I'm just putting this because going back and reading this, I'm sure I'm going to forget the context. So I'm giving myself. I'm definitely just giving myself context because some of this stuff I'm listening and I'm typing as you say it. And then if someone else starts talking, I have to like type fast. So it's like it's a lot. Yeah. I thought I clocked out at 5 o'clock. Sorry. No, but I mean our target audience is like between beginner to intermediate. So I would essentially want to revisit some of the basics, but as well as some of the stuff we don't want to bore the people who are coming to listen or coming to watch that mm-hmm. already know this. So I do like that we're including a little bit of both, a little bit of some of the beginner basics, and then covering some of the stuff that we already know. If not. Giving someone knowledge, like you know, me and Nova discussed plenty of times in earlier this morning, or what was it, yesterday, in our stream about learning stuff new. What is it?
Something like that, yeah.
All right.
I was gonna say, or even like breaking down the tank role, how there's like, what is it like, point
Hi,
or
Trinity.
Main tanks, and then off tanks, how they kind of serve a different role.
If you're not following Dark Lord Nova, go ahead and drop him a follow. But yes, that's kind of like included in this.
Yeah.
So, what were you gonna say, Nova? I feel like you were gonna add to the, or were you just asking if we were
Oh, yeah, I was just asking if we were, like, starting the conversation on comps and such.
No, or... but I feel like this is more than enough to go off of to have a conversation. We don't want to bullet point a bunch of stuff and not all get to it, because some of our meetings that we've recorded in the past have gone on to, like, an hour and a half, which I don't mind. I usually, when I stream on Wednesdays, I stay up to, like, 10:30, you know, 11, but... I also want to get a chance to play some games too. Yeah. I was like, I don't want to do this the whole time I'm streaming. I definitely want to get some games and be a hood rat. So I think this is more than enough.
I'm playing games right now.
Stinky. I can't multitask like that. UOP. I can't do that. I can't type with my left foot and then
out or something. It's because I'm mid match and I'm also like talking with my chat. I'm on push to talk. So I apologize if I don't respond instantly or something like that.
No, you are totally fine. Our meetings are lax, and I mean, honestly, our podcast is the same, to be honest.
For real.
what you might call it. No, Trent, we are talking about this. This is the three bullet points that we're basically going to cover under this topic. So anything remotely involved with any of this, if you want to add on to it, we can start like the discussion around that. Inside of Design My Personal Experiences, you can join in the VC. We're in the we're in stages, which kind of acts exactly as you would think a stage. You can choose to be a part of the live audience, or you can join the Paladins podcast panels. I mean, whatever you want to do, you're more than welcome to join on, and you should be able to see it. I think if you join in, we just have to add you as a speaker. Let me see. I think he could just request to speak too, right? And then one of you guys can let him in.
Yeah, I'll let him in. All right. Kind of busy with work right now, so I'm here. But
should be able to let him in.
Justin could too, yeah. At this point, Justin should just be mod.
Yeah, we just have to tell me how to do everything, because I don't know how to do all the shit.
No, I got you.
Just be like, Justin, type in exclamation mark this.
Well, I'm pretty sure you submitted an application. So all I would have to do is just give you the thing. I think.
If I did.
Yeah.
Sorry. If I didn't, I can.
No. I don't think you did. I'm confusing that with the Paladins panel member thing.
There you go, Trinity.
Hello, hello.
Hey, Trent.
Raze, go bye-bye.
What? He's busy at work.
What is going on?
Raze did a no-no and left the thing and came back.
Raze did a no-no, he said.
Okay, bye.
Come back.
Bye-bye.
All right, I'll turn you up. What is,
nothing much.
What's up?
Just relaxing, browsing through Twitch, and it's like, oh, at least they're a podcast. Like, oh, shit, what is this about?
Yeah, this is like Trinity, preparing. I'm about to say, I'm pretty sure you know Nova.
Because I saw Nova streaming and I overheard you guys talking about like some drafts and stuff. I'm like,
my boy, it's been ages.
This is up my alley, huh?
I literally just met Nova. Like, well, I've seen them around, but like, we just clicked recently.
Hello.
So it's kind of funny. Like, oh my god, we're all connected.
Online is really weird nowadays.
That's fucking amazing.
I love Paladins low key, like as crazy as a game be though. Like, I've been meeting some genuine people on here, and I'm not gonna lie. Like,
if we just get past all the ego people, like, this community is actually pretty decent when it comes to making connections. That's like the one and only positive thing I can say about the Paladins community.
Yeah.
As someone who's like you, me, Ellie, like as people who's been in it for over 5 years and for a long time,
yeah,
shit sucks.
Oh yeah. No, and I just love the fact that, like, you know, no matter what, I don't know, I've had some bump-ins with lots of people, but for the most part, like, I'm chill with everybody.
Yeah, I'm hanging out with you and Nova and everybody. Y'all super cool.
Oh,
and
yeah.
I hope I am too.
Like, oh, yeah.
I try to be a cool person, but also the person that carries every match. I try to do both at the same time.
Yeah. Yeah.
Carry.
It's rough when, like, so, like, the one thing I'll admit about streaming and playing with viewers and then having your friends also in the party, I'm not going to say it's a bad thing, but because I was against making alt accounts for a long, long time, but I will say this. When newer people join and they want to play with you, it's so not fair to them. I know, you know what I'm saying? It's not fair to them. It's really not. And I hate doing smurfs. I really do. Yeah. But it's necessary, honestly.
And also, I love playing with viewers, but it can be rough sometimes, for sure.
But also, in my case,
you're not ready for it.
No.
I often play with people, and they may be newer. I feel like I'm doing all the work because, like, they get overwhelmed so easily.
Yeah.
Of what's going on in game. And meanwhile, I'm here. It's like, in my mind, I know what to do because I've been playing this game for a fuck ton lot longer. But, like, people would panic if a Talus is just chasing after you. Or they hear an Andro or plus a Seraph on it. Like, what do I do? It's like, you just move. But they don't understand that as much. But I don't blame them because it's an unfamiliar circumstance.
Low-key, it's why I snapped at you last time, because I was like, you don't know it, but the person I was playing with was new. They did not. They just...
I know. Like, I'm not going to name this pattern streamer, but, like, they super chill. I like talking to them, but sometimes I get so annoyed playing with them, because, like, how the fuck are y'all throwing this back?
Bro, I'm saying, like, we were just talking. So, what game was it? Who was with me? Was that last night? When was it that I streamed and we had a Grog that fucking ulted? And even somebody from chat that lurks. It was Plies. Plies is always lurking, right? He was like, why the fuck did Grog ult? I was like, bro, I don't know what my Grog is doing. I don't know why Grog is grokking. Okay, he's not grokking. He's not grokling.
I had an Imani on my team. In ring.
He don't have the Grog in ring.
He don't got the Grog
on my team. That refused to use the dragon.
Please.
For 12 minutes.
Stop. No fucking way. No fucking way.
Oh no.
No.
It's fixed now. You can use dragon now.
It's 3-2.
They though she probably don't know. Support,
but they had a lot of shield. So we needed a dragon. We all die because we can kill them.
Did anybody buy bulldozer? Because if they didn't,
no, it was like Ash Nando.
That's hilarious. Like, so you had a free game to just do whatever. Why not? Why not? You don't get free games on Imani.
It was about to hit OT. There's like 10 seconds left.
Please.
We all die, then the dragon.
Please, bro.
And then the dragon. You know, just one last
one. You're giving me PTSD of the Grog.
I teach you that in the tutorial.
They don't.
Is actually like top tier place, you know.
Yeah.
Some goddamn miracle. Me and my friend, we managed to carry a one because he was the Andro, I was a Beric. Our two best perspective roles. We managed to carry and win a game, so we won. But still, it's like, and I asked him like, in this the weird thing is that this person requested Imani in the draft, and we're like, okay. And I told him like, everybody, my whole team.
This is
was
why
roasting,
I don't play
like,
no.
Trinity, bro, I got you beat. Yeah. I got you beat. We are in a Masters GM lobby, me and my duo, and I kid you not, we need an off tank. Every off tank is open. They didn't ban a single one for some reason. It was all controller champs, right? And this bottom pick picks Maeve when we already have a flank and we just need an off tank. And Silver 5.
She could do it.
Wait, you were in a GM match with a silver player?
Yes.
Why?
Player in a GM lobby.
Wow.
Did they get boosted?
I don't know, man.
Bruh.
It was so
first of all, that shouldn't even be possible.
Yeah, I know.
I can feel Trinity's face of confusion right now. I can feel it.
I mean, intentionally. But he's literally just a silver player.
I'm gonna be real, I've seen, played, and went against this in like tournament matches. Double flank comps can work, but you need to have good coordination and trust each other.
Yeah.
But it's like with double flank comps, you're either gonna go 4-0, or it's gonna be 3-3 and might lose.
Yeah.
Like, well, so it's one of those two scenarios.
Is he didn't know how to play anything but Maeve because he was a brand new account. He was like level 40.
Oh, yeah.
Everyone on the entire team was absolutely pissed at this guy. Like, no one liked him. We thought he was throwing. Everyone was angry. And at the end, like, most of the people in the game are flaming him, like, what are you doing? And then he's like, bro, I'm silver. I'm like, there's no shot, you're silver. And we checked it, and he's legitimately silver.
What?
How, what so the bad.
Fuck? That's not even their fault. Then. Like, they
no,
were just out.
It really wasn't. I realized it at the end. Like,
I mean, in fairness, the main pick was still bad, but, like...
Yeah.
And that's the thing
still,
about
even
it.
Even if they did pick an off-tank, it still probably would have been rough, because, like, you know, that's just silver and a fucking master, grandmaster. Like, what? Oh, no. They'd still probably be just getting shredded.
Yeah, I feel bad. They went, like... 2-20 or something like that on the match.
Oh,
it was yeah,
that's rough. Something. Surprised I didn't just like DC,
bruh. I don't know. That's kind of wild. Like that's why I can't play ranked anymore, because the last time I played ranked, I think you can still go watch that live stream. It's toxic. I fucking went off on this Barrack that, first of all, everyone that knows me knows I'm an amazing IO. There's no question about that. Trinity could even vouch for me. I've had a fucking world champion Leanne vouch for me. Like, there's no fucking way you're gonna sit here and call me a bad IO when this Barrack, if y'all please, I think it's still on my YouTube if I didn't remove it already. It's like a really old live stream on YouTube, right? And I'm just going off cussing up a storm because he was like, because you don't leave your dog near me. The fuck? I'm an aggressive IO. I need my stuns because you ain't doing shit but running to point and dying, my guy. My teammates are getting kills and pushing forward, and you're sitting on the point. And his build was nothing. I think he ended up going... It was when Forgefire, I think, just got, like, reworked or whatever. And he was going that... His build wasn't even built for it, though. And it was built around his rocket boots. So then I forgot who was in chat that was like... they were fucking trolling me. Because... I was so mad about it, and then I think it was Drifty, and he ended up fucking playing with me, and he made a build that was similar to the Barrack just to piss me off, and he got more damage than the Barrack. Like, I was like, there's no fucking way. Yes, like, it just made me laugh. Like, it straight up proved my point. Like, this guy just didn't know. But we've had this discussion on this podcast before where I'm like, if you're new, and someone is just trying to, like, give you pointers, do not snap at them, especially if they're playing better than you. Like, I'm on support at the end of the game. He was the lowest he did, and it was a ranked game. I think that was the last ranked game I chose to play because it pissed me off so much. I was like, I can't, because, like, I was starting to get good at the game at this time, and I was actually not mining ranked to the point that even my boyfriend was playing ranked. And y'all know Jamie hates fucking the game. He does not touch paladins ever. Like, he will literally only jump on when we're both drunk as fuck and he just wants to meme with us if we're doing customs. But other than that, he doesn't load. This game is uninstalled from his computer. He does not touch Paladins. Like, he hates it. But, and he hates that I play it so much. But I have a love-hate relationship with him. I do. But no, like, fucking, that was back when he was playing ranked with me. Because I think in that, if you go back and watch that live stream, he was in my party. So, like, everybody did well, except for this Barrack. And when we went and looked, he was new. And I'm like, I think I was at the time... I was getting into plat or something, but I was trying to, like, take rank serious, but I couldn't. I couldn't even give myself the chance to level back up and do anything because I kept getting newer players that didn't know anything. And it was just like, no matter how long I play this game, I can never, even now that I'm a good player, I can't. I really just can't.
I have a sad story.
I'm sorry?
Season 5 of ranked. I managed to get to Diamond 1.
Mm-hmm.
98 TP. Then they got hit with a 12 loss streak instantly.
Bruh.
Ooh. Wait, do you guys know Bobo XXL?
Yeah.
I know him. I face his scrim team.
Okay.
I face his scrim team a lot.
You know how he's doing the playing ranked every day until he gets GM?
Yeah.
You mean that he got hard carried by Layton for the first 20 days?
Oh, dude, he was brand new to the game. Cut him a little slack. But he's
I'm
like,
just
oh,
saying.
That was be nice.
That thing lasted for well over 2 months. He got carried by Layton to Diamond. I'm like, bro. Like,
dude,
I know
so
he's a decent player. I'll
was...
admit, he's a good player.
Mm-hmm.
But still, you got hard carried off the bat.
I mean, hey, let him do what he wants, you know?
Right.
I know.
I mean, he's not hit it yet.
That's just my only complaint. I know.
So, he made it within one game of GM and then hit a 5-loss streak. Like, 60
Dang.
Days in. Yeah. I felt so bad. He was actually like 10 TP away.
Yeah.
I think.
Nah.
And then got screwed over.
And it just happens like that all the fucking time, though.
Yeah. Just... No, because like my 12 loss streak was two. One of them was against a cheater. Two of them were AFKs. Two of them was someone who was win trading, basically stream sniping a female streamer and intentionally throwing games just to get attention. Yeah. And then the rest of the matches was just generally being outdrafted or I'm top damaging and we're still losing.
Yeah. Like,
that was the 12th loss streak. And I was so fucking tilted.
Yeah.
Yeah, I can only get like a 3 loss streak on ranked before I call it there, before like I actually start malding really bad.
Right, you're like, nah, we're not.
Yeah.
Honestly, I speak to a lot of my friends, because a lot of my friends that are on my tournament team.
That needs to be a whole episode, too.
Right? And I swear to God, I'm like, this may be a little bit ego of me, but I'm pretty sure I'm the best player to never hit Masters. Straight up.
Straight Damn. Up. What a title.
It is. Like, at this point, I basically call myself a master, because that's just 2TP. It's 2TP.
Yeah.
Like, close enough. But I just always wanted that border and that title. Yeah. And I never been able to get it, because the game wants me to fucking lose every match.
Well, it's just, and then the thing, we talked about this also a couple episodes ago, like, you know how we were saying, like, oh, we need to make Smurfs to, like, play with the newer players? Then you have people that don't do it for the good-hearted, right? It's, like, straight up just to, you know, hide themselves, and it's, like, ugh. And it, you know, it's multiple, it's cheaters, it's whatever, and you just never know who's doing what, and then when it does get exploited, it's, like, well, then they just make another name and do some other shit, and it's even in casuals now. Like, I stopped playing ranked because I was like, okay, cheaters are only in ranked. It's fine. Bro, they be hacking.
Sometimes casuals are unhinged.
What? Literally. Right. And it makes. Hello? Ranked. I'm like, I don't play ranked anymore. Why am I getting a cheater? I had one guy accuse me of hacking on literally Willow. You guys, Willow. What? What? She's just in a great
this update.
Exactly, so, that's my point. Yeah. But and I was good with her before the update. Everyone that knew I was getting good with her, they were like, "Yo, like, are you excited about the update?" I don't read patch notes. Yeah, yeah. But well, that's what I'm saying. Like, this made it good for Willowmates.
I have a funny story about Willow. So I was playing Willow yesterday in rain, and I have my friend, like, my tournament. I was playing one of my DPS player for my team, and then our tank player joined in. And I think player's like flex player. Like, he can really do anything. He's also extremely good. And we were just talking about it, because I picked Willow in ranked. We won the match. But the entire time they were fucking roasting me because of my Nightshade build. I dropped 150k. Like, I'm just saying.
It's good first if you can do it.
I know.
Hey, yeah.
I love Nightshade. Nightshade has always been my main talent, but Ava's running on Blast Flower because of the drift thing, and you can give it. I know.
I
but still, like, Blast
Flower
is roasting.
So strong right now.
I still think Blast Flower is stronger, but I love the Nightshade build also, because, dude, Loki, people don't expect how much burst it has.
Yeah.
Here's why I went Nightshade. Enemy team was Azan, Fernando, Ray, Sati, Andro. And the map is Water's Gate.
Ooh, that's a good map for her.
That alone has easy burst potential, because the only champion that can hard counter was just the Azan. Because there's a flank in the Sati and the Ray, I can fucking destroy half the HP with a left click, right click in less than a second.
Right.
So that's why and because it's dead zoned, Ray cannot instant heal out of it.
Right.
So that's why I went Nightshade. And it worked, because we had a Koga, my teammate, who just finished up the kills. And it's like, synergy, you know.
Mans was a whole fucking vacuum.
I know. It's just so funny. It's like, they were just roasting me the entire
time. Fun fact, my boyfriend that I mentioned that does not play this game, he has one good Nightshade build, mind you, right? This is before any of the Willow changes anything. This is like a year ago he made this build or some shit. He calls it fucking Bread Zone, and I hate him for it. I fucking hate him for it. Bread Zone. Like, I don't even think I have the build anymore, but his name in the game is Cheesy Deck. Not Dick, but Deck. D-E-C-K. So if you want to steal it from... Yeah, Cheesy Deck. Go steal the fucking Bread Zone build and let him know what you think. I personally... No,
my build names are always unhinged.
I mean, yeah, you'll... Yeah. The more you spend time here, you'll see. I'm being very innocent in front of Nova. I'm breaking him in, right? We gotta break him in before we bust him down.
I have a build after one of her catchphrases while she plays support.
Who?
I have a build called Survive, bitch.
Oh yeah. So when you're playing with me and you're one HP, right, and I see you and you think I'm not gonna heal you, I come out of nowhere and I'm like, Survive, bitch! And I like throw every healing ability.
Try get the sub to Nova. Let's go.
Stinky. Love to see it.
Anyways, well, we're gonna talk team groups. So what were you guys were talking about this? Team comps.
Oh yeah, we didn't even like get into that because we were kind of talking about other stuff, which I was throwing that in the potential episode.
We got to talk about Willow, okay?
All the Willow deserves her own episode. Unbiased opinion, just saying. So I want to talk about what, because everyone's different definition, and as Nova did bring up, like everyone's definition of what meme builds and what situations and what circumstances are. For example, my example of a meme build is completely different from you or Ray's or Justin. So I want to kind of get into the nitty gritty for those that don't know, because when I was new with the game, I didn't understand the concept, right? I was like, I get the basic comp thing, but I didn't understand what people were geeking out about with the different comps until I had to go against it. And I started getting good at the game and got in different lobbies. And I was like, oh, wow, pocket comps, circle jerk comps, we love that.
Like, I never knew I had to be good until I had to be good.
You call it circle jerk comps?
Yeah. I know. You know I'm right.
Be like this.
You know what I'm talking about. If you've gone against me in game, you've seen me call you guys out at the end of the game and say, you guys are circle jerking. I do it all the time.
Anytime there's double support, that's what I call it.
Circle jerk, yeah! Or like a Torvald. There's a Torvald.
Anytime it's a Ray with an off tank.
Yeah, yeah. A Torvald fucking Ray or a fucking Lilith Ray.
Torvald? No, I went against a Torvald Ray Terminus and I never wanted to kill myself as much as
I did.
I love it.
That's actually okay. So the one that just freaked me out the most was a Furia, Nando, Term, Ray, where the big four, and so you have the heal or the full res on Term, the full heal on Ray, the save on Nando, and the Furia to put a beam over herself and everybody to make sure they don't die. Actually, didn't want to play for the rest of the day. Like, what do you do?
Unless you have a Willow or a Tiberius, what do you do against that?
I mean, even then, Willow can only do so much.
Like,
and
like
then
you have to go Willow, like, you seriously only had to go Willow, Tiberius, or BK. And like,
yes, you don't have a choice.
It has to be one of those three, or you're just not going to win. Like, there's no other, even Drogos. Like, Drogos won't be able to do well.
No, I feel like it depends on the damage. Because
it would depend if how good the tour, like if the Terminus knows what he's doing and he knows how to siphon cycle, I can't do anything. I just can't.
Yeah, dude, good terms right now are so frustrating. And I hate people saying like how bad Term is. And in reality, he's probably one of the best tanks. You just got to build around him.
Yes.
But the Terminus moment you do, he's unstoppable.
Terminus is one of those tanks where you have to kind of draft around a term favorite situation.
Yeah, Ray too.
You can't really use him all the time. Yeah, right. Ray, you can't use him all the time, but you just have to. You just have to draft. Like even in tournament settings, like one of the most common drafts you go with Terminus, Pip Sky. Pip heal Sky.
Pip Sky. That's fair. Pip heal
Sky, and you just get a good shield tank. And then a hit scan of any kind, and you just win. Like, you just straight up win. Because you got the burst healing from the Pip, you got the sustainability from the Sky, who can also do poison pole damage. The hit scan cleans up, and the Nano just distracts. Or the Nano, the Koa, whoever's the shield.
I'm so happy Healer Sky is, like, actually in the meta now. That's so funny.
I love it. Right? Me, has someone who went Heal Sky and pop in a double... like a back support Pip in tournament matches and won with it, I can tell you it's so satisfying when you start to see it work. Because the enemy team...
Oh yeah, I love playing Healer Sky. I just don't do it often.
Yeah. And like, in terms of like, when it comes to team comps, it's scrim matches, I'm gonna tell you right now, scrim and tournament matches, is different than ranked matches. Even though it's the same,
a lot of my Hylo stuff, it's like a poking game almost. There's not really much happening. It's like a battle of HP bars a good bit of the time. Like, you both poke and prod,
yes, because
and then
it's
like
time
you're
to go to bed. So late.
Your flank will like keep trying to do something and then fail, and then you back up a little, and then it's just rinse repeat over and over and over until you get a team wipe.
Yeah. And then like when it comes to tournaments, like you're not only drafting, you're drafting to basically win everything. As much as you're not
Hi,
just to stay alive or anything. You're like one of the most common comps with a AoE heal with a sky double support and then an off tank. Like a zoning off tank. And you, that was a common draft all throughout the tournament season of April. Like all the top teams ran it. And all the top teams consistently had very good results because
you guys.
Just how the maps are structured in a way you just abuse that close coordinates. There's not much you can do.
Right.
Now the only
Trinity, do you know who Bullet is?
Yes.
Yeah, I was talking with Bullet about comps the other day, and we were talking about like how overpowered hyper aggro is right now.
Especially
how
with
the
bro combo. Oh my
god.
It's
just so strong, dude.
Like okay. Pip IMO. Pip is only good at high elo.
Yeah. I think
low elo pip players don't know what they're doing. High elo pip players would just
I think I'm just spoiled because I was taught how to damage pip by Adam Carson, and he's like a really good pip player. Damage pip player. So like my elo is very low in my opinion. Like it's high because I played with fucking sneaky ass people, but realistically literally my own lobbies, even without you, like I don't need you in my lobbies. The game thinks I'm meant to be in your lobbies for whatever reason, because I play with you, I play with Andy, I play with fucking Daddy Mouse, like I fucking play with everybody, and
my lobbies suck.
Yeah, it's just I hate my lobbies. I'm in hell lobbies, okay? They don't make sense at all. You're giggling.
Everybody,
you know exactly
ego,
what I'm talking about.
No one wants to have fun. That's my lobbies. Anybody egos, no one wants to have fun.
But the thing is, though, I'll admit, me becoming semi-decent has made it to where when I come across people that I know are good, I can hold my own against them now. I'm noticing I'm winning those 1v1s. I'm winning. Like, it's satisfying in a way because they may not remember me, but it's like, I remember you, bitch. You shit on me when I was new, and now I can shit on you. On Willow. Dude, the other day I got to kill an Andro out of the sky with Willow, and it made me so...
Let's go.
So happy. I was like, you can eat my whole ass with a spoon. I was so happy.
Yeah, I feel like I'm at a very comfortable elo where like my games aren't sweaty, but every now and then just a random GM will pop in and it'll become like a really high stakes game, and it's really fun.
Yeah.
I wish that was my case.
Like that untouchable.
That sounds nice. You can buy that?
Really,
where you get that at?
That's my case.
No, it's enjoyable. But then I always run a stack of like masters and GM players, so it's kinda I do kinda feel bad sometimes.
it's wild because then like I was watching, when was it, the one that you told me to watch, the stream that you sent to watch your Nessa shots? I'm like watching the game,
the
game. And you're like damn.
Dude,
they gave up
that game.
Bro,
I'm not
that
a good Nessa player.
Yeah, no, but there was the other, there was like I watched the stream I think completely, and there was like there was a TDM game. I'm pretty sure that was the same game. That was the Nessa game, I'm pretty sure.
Julie,
I don't remember what the fuck you were playing. I just remember the team gave up, and I felt bad. I was like, dang.
Yeah, it happens.
Wait.
All right, what were we saying, Trinity?
According to Dark Nova stream chat, Julie, what are you playing against him?
Who, what, Frog? Mrs. Frog?
Yeah.
Yeah, we were just against Frog.
He's one of my teammates.
Oh, nice. Yeah,
who was he? Yeah, who was he?
They played Ying.
Cringe.
Yeah. No, they ran double tank, double support against us, by the way.
He's doing it with Astro. They do it with Astro. That makes sense. Okay. Yes, they do. He's with Astro, who is a support one trick.
I gotcha. Yeah, no, I just I know Frog from Seth, friend of a friend. Seth is a really, really good friend of mine.
I know Seth.
Seth's actually goated, dude.
Well, stinky as fuck.
Five stack? There's no way you're five stacking. Wait, let me hold on. Let me do that. Let me do some investigation.
Investigation.
Right, give me one moment. Let me do an investigation.
Invest the trend. Trendgation. I want to save this part for a raise, but I think he had to. We got busy at work.
No, I'm here.
Okay, so the emoji video, because I did see it on my break earlier.
From two stack.
I did watch it. I saw it. And I know that someone said they think emoji is going to be really strong. I think the Nova said that. What do you think as far as like, because a lot of people, I don't know, from what I've seen in the comments, whenever they first posted the changes, a lot of people were like anti it because they were like, well, they felt like playing aggressive emoji, it's going to ruin her. And I'm like, no, are you kidding? Like, if maybe if you don't want to heal your teammate, that's fine. But like, you can heal yourself. Like, I'm pretty sure it's not going to affect it that much, in my opinion, unless they're reworking too.
I'm just curious on how they reworked her talents.
Who, emoji?
The talents are interesting.
The talents.
I really like what they did with Scamper talent. I think that's
I added a pretty good diversity.
But that's what I'm asking. Like, are you guys happy about that? Because so many people were negative about it. But personally, I'm excited. I think that's a good change.
I have to try it out before I have my opinions.
I don't want to self-advertise, but I literally made a video briefly talking about the emoji change. Just saying.
That's fun.
But still, in my personal opinion, I definitely think as a solo healer, she's not that good. But if you pair it with a self-sustained team, like an Anora, Terminus, etc., she can work.
Yeah, I don't think she's good by herself, but it's because she doesn't really have a good way to defend herself, is what I've noticed.
Yeah.
She has the shield doesn't make her immunity. Yeah. I would run her down easy.
Yeah, I would tell you right now, Rey plus Moji is the new meta.
I was thinking the exact same thing.
Yeah. Someone else said that too.
That's probably just going to be like too much healing.
I'm pretty. Justin, did you say that last time we were talking about that? Someone said that shit.
Yeah, Ray's extension talent got reworked to where she now has two charges of her heal. They move a little slower, but she has two charges, so she can just constantly have a heal out. Literally all the time with like level 1 Chronos.
Yeah, so what I'm thinking is Hyper Aggro, Nando, Rey, Moji, Yaggaroth, and then a filler damage or filler flank to secure picks, like a Leon or a Vatu.
Someone with good burst,
That's what I'm thinking. And it's going to be atrocious. Just crazy.
Yeah, that's what I was saying. Like, I think from what I've seen, DR. I haven't got to test it myself, but from what I've seen, Moji seems like a strong healer, but she does kind of struggle by herself, especially with the range, like when she's trying to heal up teams that are very spread out. But like teams that are pretty grouped up, like on Ice Mines and stuff, for example, like your team's usually somewhat grouped up in the line.
Sorry.
Again, this is just from viewing others.
I missed what we were talking about because I had to talk to Kaden real quick.
I was still talking about double support.
Oh, okay. Fucking hate double support, bro. I fucking hate it.
Yeah. We think that Moji's going to bring it back, though.
Yeah. A lot of people have been hinting at it.
It's not going away.
Yeah, it's been.
It's just changing people.
It's changing people. Yeah. People are forced to adjust.
Making it more relevant.
I just want any again. That's all I want. I don't give a fuck.
I want Choose Any. Yes. Like, bring that shit fucking back, man.
Choose Any.
Please, let me run with five of the same tanks.
Right, bro, they took away a good chunk of my content on YouTube because I made so many meme videos with that. We did all Genos.
All Torb.
It's working! I think we went against like all Victors, right? And we kept killing the Victors. They were so poo-poo.
Oh no. There's grenades everywhere.
I love Nate spam Victor so much.
It is so fun. I don't care what anyone says. It is not wise, but it's fun as fuck.
Right. More satisfying than a perfectly placed grenade that kills someone across the map.
That shit fucking Chictor. Like we call him Chictor. Like well, Jess calls him Baby Legs. I think that's a funny ass name.
Yeah. Now.
So, are we done?
My only problem with Moji.
You have a problem with Moji? Oh my god.
My only problem, I like that she's a point, and I think so far she's in a solid state. Like, she's not, from what I've had experience, she's not too strong, but she's not too weak, right?
Mm-hmm.
Right.
My concern is pre-buff Io, where her charge is so inconsistent in, like, a necessity, her sparkle mechanic. Because it has a much lower ammo than a default Grok or a default Io.
Hmm.
And so you kind of...
Can't
kinda,
you fix it with cards, though? I didn't look at her cards.
You can expand it, yes, but just by default, it's the lowest. Only by a few units, but it's still the lowest. And on top of that, the heal is still inconsistent because it changed the spit speed. So you can't consistently hit those charged shots like you can currently. So you basically have to essentially play Moji with like a Caspian second charge shot from his talent.
I don't like that.
That's the thing about Moji what I personally don't like. Now, we won't know until default update drops.
Right,
because a lot of supports got changed. Like, every single support got changed.
Yeah, I heard
and
a lot of...
the bonus woods, the curative woods, whatever they're called.
They're all removed.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
Let's go.
Yeah.
And Grover is removing their curative woods.
Yeah.
So, at the moment, in my personal mindset, I'm definitely placing Moji probably like a low B tier as a support. Mm-hmm. And whether she get changed or not, if I had to buff her right now, I'd buff her default sparkle count, and then I would also slightly make, I would revert her spit speed. Would be my two changes I would make to make her a viable solo heal.
I didn't actually play the PTS outside of like 10 minutes to experience it, so I can't say. Like, with a definitive yes or no, if I believe she's overpowered or not. But as of right now, I do think she's like B or A tier. I don't think she's like game breaking, but I think with the right comp, she's gonna be impossible to deal with.
I think she's not dog shit healer.
I looked at him getting rid of magic barrier, and like as a flank player, I was like, oh yeah, this is good. my life 10 times easier now.
Yeah. Trent, I'm curious, what do you think your projected win rate's gonna be?
In what?
In ranked. Or in just in general. And people picking her and playing her since this rework. Do you think more people are gonna care to try her as a support or still try to play her as a fucking flank? Cause you know people try to do that shit. They're like,
I think Playmoji is dead.
Fucking matchmaking. I'm already sitting at 40% win rate. Like, I don't know how worse I can get right now.
Oh,
gotta feel that, dude.
And it's so sad. It's so fucking sad.
I hate hearing that for you, cause I'm like, please, like you shit on everyone. Oh, dude.
Like I'm like, for a person my skill, I should not be having 40% win rate, but I get it because I just get last pigs who don't know what the fuck they're doing, and it's like, it's so frustrating.
Yeah. Last pick level 2 Corvus.
That Amani story was kind of wild.
Last pick silver 5 Maeve.
Like, no. Like, I was dueling with one of my teammates last night in ranked, and he witnessed my luck when it comes to teammates, and it's so fucking... It's the Amani I was talking to you about.
Yeah.
Earlier. Literally. It was with him.
Yeah, I feel like my ranked is cursed like that as well.
Really having a good game. It's 2-0, and then someone on my team leaves and doesn't come back. I'm like, what the fuck?
Right. That's what I'm saying. Why are we leaving when we win? Like, what? I don't... Why? Because you don't get your way? Like, please go suck your own dick. Like, what are you doing? Why the fuck are you leaving when we're winning? I hate that. That's so dumb.
I hate it too.
It's so dumb.
Right, so on the topic of Moji, you guys know the bug where you can play with no talent and no build, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. I haven't.
I wonder how she perform like that.
Oh my god.
I do that with Aura just to like see how strong she is in base kit.
Yeah.
And I play around with it, but I wonder how Moji will be able to perform with that kind of thing. And I'm hoping it's decent, is my thing. I'm really hoping it's decent, because if the base kit can be played around with, I think it'll be really good for the overall health of the character.
True, if the base kit is viable enough.
Yeah, for sure.
That's a fair thought.
Hold on, chat real quick.
Custom mode, I think we should try one day too. Just not playing with no talent.
Play a custom mode with no talent, yeah.
Yeah, no talent.
I do it every now and then. It's very fun.
Ooh, it's no talent custom.
It's super disorienting.
I was just thinking about it. I was like, I've never thought of that. I was like, how
could you? Because you could disable the talents on there. So we could do that. We haven't done that, I don't think.
That would make some characters really strong, others very, like.
That'd be so funny, though.
but you know, with the usual movement speed and all that.
Oh my god, I love our customs. They're so fun. Y'all are more than welcome to join. We
customs
literally make the jump height mad high. Like, remember when I decreased it and we're like popcorn, like boop, 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 boop,
threw me so off. I was like,
what the fuck? Yeah, people who like Batu. Yeah. Imagine Batu, he's supposed to be in the sky and he's like, I can't. My pee-pee's broken. So I'm about to put a lore in chat so that people can vote what lore requests we should do on champs. Because there's like a lot.
Now, I know a lot about personal lore. I have not been keeping up with the Chronicles.
I haven't.
Like, in terms of, like, in lore events and in lore changes with the Chronicles and how the characters are interacting, I'm fucking clueless on that shit.
Me too.
But, like, in terms of lore-wise, everything else, I got it down packed.
Yeah.
I know about Vora, Yag, and that's about it.
I know everybody.
Yeah,
but like if it was anything related to Chronicles, I don't know what Chronicles about. I have not read any of them, and they took down the website, so it's like I can't even fucking read it in the first place.
Yeah, I know. Like, give me something.
Like, okay,
it's just sad.
I feel like Powders is downgrading, like the company.
Yeah, I don't know why they took down the door. That was
first they took away update shows. They got rid of update shows, which I love that.
Yeah,
that actually made
they've just lost a lot of funding over the years. That's honestly
and
what
now,
it comes down to. Money.
And now they've lost
the
goddamn website. So you had to go to the Steam page.
Yeah, and it's upsetting because it's like, I don't want to go on Steam to know about what is going on. Like, I want to be able to.
What we got here? That one's the most interesting one.
I want to do one on Vatu because I don't think we've done Paladin's Bingo on my stream in the past.
I know Vatu lore.
I don't know a lot about Vatu lore, surprisingly. Like, and that's what I'm saying. Yeah, like we used to do Paladin's Bingo and do like the different lore, and that was fun. And then I stopped doing it. And
Vatu actually has some pretty cool lore.
Girl, we need to do a whole episode. Like I said, Willow deserves her own episode.
I can spam vote with my two. Ooh.
Oh,
I can skew the
butthole.
So
I'm gonna have to pick Willow and like get to you, Becky.
Yeah, it's just not picking Willow.
No, I can't spend. I can't spend.
Hey, he's cheesing it.
He's cheesing the fuck out of boy.
In fair.
Wait, can I spit?
I also did. But
oh, I can spit. All right, I give everybody three. Okay. I would give everybody three votes.
I'm done. He's like, I'll be free.
Anybody gets five votes.
Bruh.
Wait, what? Sorry.
In my chat, we're doing.
I have no clue what's happening.
We're doing a poll of my chat, and he's spamming his fucking bugabucks to do Vatu lore. It's Vatu's got like 21 fucking votes. And everybody else has like five or six votes.
I'm sitting at a pretty 2.2k.
He's like, I'm gonna use all my pujas.
I just earned 50. All right, I'm gonna bump up Willow, but like.
Oh, six, I like Furia's ult too. Furia's ult, wow.
And, I mean, everybody loves Furia's ult.
Furia lore is also pretty cool. I like it. It intertwines with Cyrus a lot.
Boy, brought you staying in the first place.
And Corvus.
Someone, you're gonna start a fight with someone.
Furia and Cyrus are sisters, right?
Yes.
I'm
not mistaken.
Yeah, they are.
Yeah.
Abby and Cyrus.
I found that out like a year after I started playing, and I was like so amazed by that. I think
Abby
I was mind blown.
Was Cyrus and Sarah,
and Sarah
was Furia.
Is Furia.
I find that so interesting.
That's confusing.
Yeah. Because I would have been like, it would have made sense.
So Cyrus's name, I'm gonna spoil the.
We have to do that on the podcast. This is a meeting.
In the lore video for Cyrus and Tiberius, just want to let you know.
Bro, okay, hold on.
No, that's what I'm saying. Like, I love Tib. I get too excited, and I'm just gonna spill all the beans.
I know you gotta wait for the podcast on Saturday. Right? You gotta wait till Saturday. This is just the meeting.
You heard me slam the e. I pulled the e-brake. I was like, skrr.
Justice said he was like, pull up a chair. Too late. My chair is pulled up high. Who is fighting with them in the boat? Two foot Furia.
Welcome. Shall we continue?
It's looking like it's just a tie between Furia and Vati, pretty much. I could put the both of them down.
Wait, you talk about ties?
Oh! Who is keeping up this fight? What is happening? Who is doing this right
now? Oh, no. Hell no.
My cheeks hurt. Now. This is too much.
There is a fight.
Oh my god, I cannot. They're doing it like right as you do it, dude. Damn. This is really a 1v1 with Bugabucks. Like, what is going on? And then we got Willow, Moji, Makoa, just unimportant. Just nope.
It's a game of chicken. That's what it
is. Y'all are wild. Well, y'all fight that out. I'm just about to.
That's fine. I'm a roll blunt.
I'm gonna whoever's spam me.
Who is doing
on three? Okay. One, two, three.
Okay. Y'all both kind of did it like one extra after, but I saw that. So it's a tie. Whoever this is, they're not letting it go. Like, you only get a tie.
Wait, no. Actually, no. On your win, you can see who voted.
I can? Oh, I have to pull up my thingy. Hold on.
Yeah, you should be able to see who voted.
Let's
You should log
see.
Who voted.
I gotta go over here when I manage the poll. Let's see. Channel point contributors. It was just you using channel points. Hey, fuck a Arky.
No, who's at 45? Who's okay, it's a tie.
Damn. That's cool. I can put them both on there. That was funny to watch.
I will not be defeated.
Fucking raise.
The Paladin is tricky. Let's go, boys.
That was fucking Raze fighting you.
Wait, who?
Fucking Raze.
Bruh.
He's like, I will not be defeated. So Furia Vatu.
Not Willow. Pop up Vatu and pop over.
I mean, I didn't really care. I just enjoyed the fucking.
That event. Was we look. Y'all are just competitive heathens for no reason. Stop, bud. All right, so Furia Vatu.
Raise a hand if you were there for both champion releases.
I was not there for the Furia one. I was not. Was I around for Vatu? Wait, I think I was around for Vatu, yeah.
You
I was.
Were here for both Vatu and Furia release.
I am back.
Not both, but nope, I was here I for was. Vatu.
I was. I remember
I
watching.
I remember Vatu was stinky.
Me?
Furia was pretty early on. She was one of the early.
Oh, I started in fucking 2016, dude.
Yeah, so I played the beta.
Somewhere same
and
me.
Then I quit until Maeve released, and then I played Maeve on the Xbox, and then
what's
I quit
beta?
Until Fury
you played
released,
Maeve on controller.
And then I quit until
oh
about a year
shit!
And a half back.
No way. What's beta? Closed or open?
Closed.
Oh, I always wanted to play closed beta. Like when I saw things, like I missed out, dude. Because I literally no. joined. I joined like. Right after.
Right?
Yeah, I know. Yeah, yes. It's a siege map. It's a siege map. Yeah, I mean,
wait, you said you joined
map.
After Con 2?
The payload maps are the,
It was right after Con was released when I joined it.
I played when it was
that was when I had first played it.
It was like Mine, Sky, Fernando, but
yes, it was the original 8. The original
King wasn't even in the game.
Wasn't it like,
yes.
Barrick? Wasn't he one of the original?
No, it was it? No, it was...
I thought it was Nando Barrick, right?
Sky, Nando... Yes, it was Nando. Sky, Nando, Buck... Barrick, Grover,
Cassie was in there.
Cassie
was a new champion released later, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Because he was no, a not Grover. When he first released. Grover went in the game when I played.
It was not Sarah Grover.
Was in,
Grock. It was Grock. It was Grock. The... Grock is the
original. Oh, Grock. That's right. Grock. Grock.
The other original ones would be...
I don't remember the others. I really don't.
Damn, it's been that long?
Victor, I think.
No, Victor wasn't in the game.
Yeah.
Or wait, was he?
Victor wasn't an OG.
He was.
That's funny because he's in the fucking tutorial.
Because Knessa came a few months later.
Maybe I'm just crazy. Well, didn't Knessa release right after Andro? They released within
Androxus,
the same month.
Yes, Androxus is one of the other OGs.
Is that when they were releasing characters like every month?
No,
basically?
No, this was yeah, that was like during like that was during like 2017. That was 2017, 2018, where they just pumped out champs like nothing.
Yeah,
I think I came post that because I came when Vora was new and everybody was like another new champ, and I was like, huh? And
then eventually,
and I was like, man, this game wild.
Because of it hit OB64.
Oh yeah, OB64. I'm so glad I didn't play back then.
I've
watched so much videos and like YouTubers talking about it, and I'm just like, I remember who broke it down for me to understand. Matter of fact, I remember. So he doesn't even stream this content anymore. He actually like disavowed fucking Paladins for obvious reasons, but fucking Cyberball. Like I watched a bunch of his shit, and he broke that down, and I just laughed. I was like, this sounds like a nightmare. Like I didn't realize a game could have that much fucking weight. It was just wild. I went through that whole roller coaster just like listening to different creators talk about their experience, and I'm like, that sounds so horrible. Like what the fuck? Imagine to hype a game up so much and then get slapped in the face. And then it still does it. I'll give them their props where it's due, but like I'm trying to be devil's advocate, if that makes sense. Cause I don't get to speak on the bad because I wasn't there for it. So I can't just jump on the bandwagon and be like, ugh, hate this, hate that, because I don't fucking know. I can speak on what the fuck I see now, and it's a whole lot of bullshit, but I'm allergic to bullshit, so we're not talking about that. Anyways, the lore request on... my name is not Evie, thank you, bye. My mom is. My mom's name is Evie, actually, which is hilarious because her heart is cold. Anyways, so Video Project and IES. We were talking earlier about alt usage, or for a brief moment, I think because we were just talking about the comps, and I thought to myself, alt usage would be a really good, like... We could do a custom video or something and like explain some of the alt usages, especially with the combo alts, because a lot of people don't understand. Like when I was newer, I never understood the concept of combo alt. I think my first combo alt was Torvald Ceres on fucking Trade District, just memeing. I was like, you want to time our alts? And she was like, yeah. And we did it. And it was hilarious. I would have had a Penta, but someone fucking shot. Yeah, it's satisfying.
Yeah, I almost always try to wait until I see somebody else has their ult before I use mine.
Alright.
Even if I'm like, I've got my ult, next person's like 50, 60%.
Yeah.
Like,
so I poured it up.
I might use this just for a solo kill.
You ported?
I poured it up. I have all the OGs champion.
Oh shit.
OGs are Sky, Ruckus.
Oh wow.
Pip, Ruckus?
Ruckus?
Grock. Fernando.
Yeah, I remember Ruckus because I played him
Cassie,
for a little bit.
Barrick. And Buck. Or the 8 OGs.
Okay.
Oh, yeah, okay. I knew those.
Ruckus and Pip threw me off. I didn't think Pip was one of the OGs.
The next 5 champions, Eevee, Grover, Knessa, Androxus, Ying, then Druggos. That was 6.
Yeah, okay. I knew Knessa and Andro were like maybe
game
a month
was so bare
art.
Bones on early days. Really, Small Blue? You play too?
I joined...
Yeah,
now,
Barrick was like the only tank back then.
I've seen videos of it. It looks wild. It looks so boring.
I joined when Madamba dropped because I remember seeing the update show for Shaolin.
Mm.
Which Shaolin came out in November 10th, 2016.
I love that it came out on my birthday.
Madamba came out in October 13th, 2016. So between October 13th and November... Somewhere in those 2.5 weeks was when I started playing the game.
Wow.
Now, OGs, remember when Grover was a melee champion and Buck was a tank?
Was a tank.
So I hear that all the time because I made the stupid decision. I was early on, new at this game, right? I asked. I was like, why is? I was reading through the talents, and I was like, what is this bulk up shit? And someone explained to me, it used to be a fucking
walls,
tank. I'm like, what?
Okay, the walls, the Buck, because Buck. Okay, so Azan Walls used to be in a Buck ability from OG.
Yeah.
Wow.
Azan Wall, but Inara's
Wall. I was so happy.
What?
Back. I was like, yes.
Here's another fun fact. Io's bow is the original model for Cassie.
I always thought that. I always thought that because I've seen a clip of Io's old Cassie's.
Similar
It is
the original model, based on the original model.
That makes me so depressed because I want bow Cassie.
That's Cassie's bow. Because what Cassie would do, she would tilt her bow upside down and pull it back, kind of like what Io does, but like full on pull back, like an archer would.
Yeah.
And then if she wanted to do a blast shot, she kind of like flicks her wrist and it shoots a special arrow off to the side. That would be her blast shot.
Yeah.
So you would like shoot, shoot, flick wrist, shoot, shoot, dash back, flick wrist. Her dash animation is the exact same. They somehow managed to do somersaults perfectly, but they can't even do a fucking mochi dash without bugging out. Let that sink in.
Oof, you hurt my whole soul with that. I've like I felt that. Oof.
Wait, Cassie dash hasn't changed since it's been put in.
Her somersault has stayed the same.
She's OG. That's a
Justin's mind is blowing currently.
Her somersault has stayed the same.
The only thing that hasn't changed.
But they cannot make consistent movement for newer champions. Let that sink in.
That's a good ability too, and like it's not like a blink or anything. It actually travels the body.
It is the only, to my knowledge, is the only movement animation with three different animations.
Now still much better.
It's the only movement ability with three animations.
Oh, from like side to side, front back.
Yes, the only one.
Kaden, open the door.
No other champion has that. Although,
not even Vatu.
Nope, not even Vatu.
I guess he just kind of does like an up jump when he does his little thing.
Yes, it's the same thing, it's just different directions. But in terms of like actually full body movement, Cassie's the only one.
Yeah.
And also, to my knowledge,
like she'll do a backflip when she goes
back. Yeah.
Like a
and
forward.
I always enjoyed that
forward.
Too. Yes. That animation.
And to my knowledge, and somebody can prove me wrong, this drug. I think Drogo's, I'm pretty sure, is the only champion with two alt animations.
He has two alt animations?
One when
like
he's,
when he's
flying,
in the air and when he's and on the ground.
And when he's on the ground. If you watch a Drogo's alt on that, in the flying, he just pulls his body back.
Right.
Like he's kind of like crunching his body. Mm-hmm. Like in a, if he's on the ground, he would actually place his claw on the ground and scoot his back leg up like he's ready
what
to dash.
The fuck?
It's kind of cool. It's super cool.
Wait,
it's
I've never noticed that. Now I kind of
because
want to
the animation has two different animations for if you hit someone below threshold and above threshold.
Oh.
Yeah.
I don't think I've ever noticed that.
You can do with that as well.
Yeah, I can showcase. I can launch a game and showcase in voice chat. Like I can share my screen.
No, I know there's a funny bug that I've never been able to replicate on command with Vora where you can insta kill anyone above threshold with her ult. I've just never been able to replicate it.
Have you guys,
I think I know what you're talking about.
have you guys ever did alt cancel on alt animation cancel emoji?
Maybe.
So basically what you do is that when you use your Bon Appetit, you press E, right? And then the moment you press E, press Q. It cancels your animation, but it still shoots the transformation. So you have your force field up as you're eating them and you cannot take damage.
It actually still goes up because it just cancels out.
I don't think I've done it before.
It cancels the animation so you can instantly.
Also guys, just a time warning, we're at an hour, so I'll definitely have to cut this down.
It's so funny. Like, it's the best because when you eat somebody with Bon Appetit, you are locked down from any ability.